MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Ought to be a good one here between the Detroit Tigers and the Seattle Mariners. It's Mariners baseball, and it comes your way next. Marco Gonzalez, the native of Colorado, gets the start on the mound. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, we're getting a chance to look at a guy that he's a little bit up and down throughout points of his career. A career ERA just over four. When he's good, he can be really good. And when he's bad, well, let's just say he can be pretty bad at times. But it'll be interesting to see which one we see. He's a little bit of Jekyll and Hyde. Hopefully he's going to be a little bit more Jekyll than Hyde in this one here today.
He's set. Here it comes. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. Our temperature should get us up into the 70s as we move along. 68 at first pitch. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here. On, he goes down to get the curveball there and gets a lot of it. And he got more than enough of it, in fact. This one is gone, a home run. A solo shot here for
Well, this has started off certainly quick. First batter of the game goes deep. Dare I say, ambush tactics?
Batting second, the shortstop, Nico.
Into the box, Nico Goodrum. As he takes a called strike at the knees, it's 0-1. His career numbers against this pitcher, he's gone 3-for-6. Here's the 0-1. Checks his swing, but this will be strike two call.
Hey, after that extra base hit, things could go awry. He didn't. He battled right back in his zone with a nice executed pitch.
Bases are empty here, nobody out. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Fraley is there, and he makes the catch for the out.
Batting third, the designated hitter, Miguel Cabrera.
So one away here with the bases empty, and that brings in Miguel Cabrera. First delivery to him on the way. A ball and no strikes. Now it's 2-0. Bases are empty, one man out. Two balls and a strike.
Gutsy pitch right there. 2-0 changeup for a strike. Good call by the catcher. Great execution by the pitcher.
Now the 2-1 pitch is an off-speed pitch taken for a ball.
Well, you can see here, this has been a steady diet of off-speed pitches, and what has it gotten him? Not a whole lot as he's...
And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. Now here it comes. That's inside. 2-0.
Well, this is a spot you'd like to be in. 2-0, good hitter. He's going to turn it loose right here.
Now here's the pitch. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0.
I'd be shocked if this wasn't a four-pitch walk right here. He doesn't want to mess around and leave something over the heart of the plate and get beat in this situation.
And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play. Grounded down the third baseline, but this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. Popped him up. Murphy has a play. But another look here at the solo shot leading off the ball game. On to the bottom of the first, and the Tigers are off and running early. It's 1-0. Matthew Boyd, the southpaw out of the state of Washington, will be the starter. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
Striding in, Shed Long. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The second baseman, Shed Long.
Now here's the pitch. Lays off 1-0.
Count 1-0.
The pitch. And that one misses upstairs. 2-0. Long stands 5'8" tall. Bats left, throws right. He was a 12th round selection back in the draft of 2013.
Hey, this guy's got a chance to be an absolute steal. Being drafted where he was, there are definite signs that he has a chance to make an impact at the big league level.
Started to chase that time, but then he wisely holds off for ball three. Swing and a miss, good pitch, and it's full now, 3-2. And a fastball misses there, ball four.
Well, there's only a one-run cushion to play with, so he's got to be upset after he walked the leadoff man here. Go-ahead run comes to the plate, and there are no outs. This could be a very interesting inning.
And that'll bring in J.P. Crawford. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. From the belt, the pitch. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Now a throw over, and he'll get back in safely. A 1-1. Misses for the second ball.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
A runner at first with no outs here. Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1.
He's having a really hard time finding his rhythm and finding the strike zone. It's going to allow this offense to keyhole him in big situations. He's got to figure it out pretty quick.
The 3-1 pitch. And boy, that misses as well. It's back-to-back walks to start out the inning.
Well, this guy's been prone to giving up walks in bunches, and that's already two walks here in the early going. We'll see if this continues to be an issue for him as this start continues.
Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. From the stretch, here's the pitch. And that's dead center for strike one.
This is where, as a hitter, you need to slow your thinking. You know he's trying to get you a double play ball right here. You have to control the strike zone.
One pitch on its way. And a fastball way off target here, and it's even at one.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
And that'll bring in Tom Murphy as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. Murphy, a former Colorado Rocky, he was acquired via trade last year.
I know he'd tell you he'd like to be playing a little bit better, but I think it's as advertised for this ball club right now. I think the manager is getting exactly...
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. A couple of walks, but no damage. Don't touch that dial, or the remote for that matter. More on the show right after this. Second inning set to go, and that means Jonathan Scope will get ready at the plate.
The second baseman, Jonathan
Scope. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. That one's down around the knees, taken for a strike. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll flip on to first to record the out.
That is it.
Okay, here's how the Mariners are going to line up defensively. And I'm going to focus on J.P. Crawford right now. He is one of the slickest defenders in the game. Real smooth going to his left and right, and he has a bazooka for an arm.
The next batter, Jamer Candelario. He'll swing and lift a ball foul off to the left and out of play. One out, nobody on. Now a changeup in on the hands that evens it at 1-1. Base hit, line drive into the corner. And now it'll kick around in the corner.
That's the game plan right there. Elevate the sinker from the offensive standpoint. That's what they talked about in the hitters meeting. And on the flip side, if the pitcher doesn't get that pitch down, there's going to be a call to the pen shortly.
Up next steps Kristen Stewart. Offered at and missed. Here's the throw. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw.
Well, he's got a cannon for an arm back there behind the dish, but it doesn't mean it's always accurate. Got plenty behind this one, but he sailed it, and he won't be happy with himself about that throw.
Now the 0-1. That misses wide. One ball and one strike.
Clearly staying away from him in this at-bat with that runner in scoring position tells me they're trying to force him to reach for something and maybe roll over on it.
A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. And it's two balls and two strikes now. In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning.
Flat out locked him up with the changeup right there. Usually you're trying for a swing and miss when you throw that pitch in a two-strike count, but clearly he wasn't looking for it, so it's a backwards K for him.
Into the box now, Austin Romine, as the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. Comes set, the 0-1. Now a swing and a ball popped in the air back behind short. Crawford has it for out number three. One hit, one left. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two. It's the Tigers one and the Mariners nothing. Leading off the inning, Daniel Vogelbach. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Number 20.
Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. Right side, defense aligned perfectly. Scope is there, and a good throw gets him one gone.
Batting fifth, the right fielder, Kyle Lewis.
So coming to the plate, Kyle Lewis, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Now here's the pitch.
1-0.
Swung on and missed. 1-1.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
And that misses. 2-1. The pitch. Fouled off. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
In now, Jake Fraley. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. We'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Ground ball left side. Reined in. And no chance on the throw. So a great effort, but that'll be scored a base hit.
Hey, that's a heck of an effort by the shortstop right there to leave his feet and try and make that throw to first base. Got to be frustrated a little bit as a pitcher. You executed your spot.
Well, I tell you what, you know, as soon as you throw one like that, D-Roy, you see your shortstop get a glove on it, you're thinking, okay, maybe he has a shot to get him, but that's a long throw after that jump throw, and it's solid infield base hit, but very frustrating as a pitcher.
From the belt, the pitch. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one.
This is where you got to take stock in the situation. Adjust your batting gloves and realize you need a gapper to score this guy from first. If nothing less, pass the baton to the guy behind you and keep the line moving.
That evens it up, 1-1. Now a throw over to first, and he'll be back in standing up. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Two out with the man at first. In the dirt, and now let's see. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away as that'll be scored a wild pitch.
And things have really unraveled on him in a hurry. He gives up a two-out single, then he throws a wild pitch to put him into scoring position. He basically just threw a double, and he didn't even earn it.
Here's the 2-2. And a fastball called strike three, and the side is retired. Mariners leave one. They're down 1-0. Jacoby Jones the next to hit. As we are all set to begin the third inning in this one.
Jacoby Jones.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Oh, that's good.
The 1-0. And he goes and chops this one out towards second. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. Here's Cameron Maben now. He got a hold of one and went yard in his first appearance in this one.
And that's been the entire offense so far in this one. They've been shut down other than that.
Here comes the first pitch. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone. Bases are empty. One man out. 2-0 now.
I wonder if that homer rattled him a little bit. He's certainly a little bit more cautious against him this time around.
Ready with the 2-0 pitch.
Yeah. You got two balls, one strike.
Swung on and missed, and it's even at 2-2. In the air now out to left field. Fraley is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now.
Now batting.
Now at the plate, Nico Goodrum, 0-1 for him here in this one. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Started to go around, but it's ruled strike one anyway.
Not the ideal location for a changeup up in the zone, but he got away with it.
A ball and a strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Line drive to left. That gets down, and the inning continues. So that at-bat extends the inning for Miguel Cabrera.
Heck of a job by the batter right there. You would have thought, but gets an off-speed pitch, doesn't try and do too much, and drives it for a base hit.
And that'll bring up the veteran Miguel Cabrera. Hit it hard, but lined out in his first at-bat.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
First offering on its way. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Running. Pitch inside. The throw. Not in time as he steals second.
This catcher has an elite arm. But when you get that great of a jump at first base, it makes it a lot easier to steal second.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Takes this the other way to right. And the stolen base winds up as a moot point as the inning is over. One left for Detroit, but they lead it 1-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Malik Smith. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Hit down the line at first, but a foul ball here, 0-1. Right there, and it's quickly 0-2 now. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Just flat out froze him there. Nothing too deceptive about that four-seam fastball, so I think he wasn't expecting it at all.
So now to the plate, Shed Long. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. Second trip to the plate for him. He drew a leadoff walk in the home first. The 0-1.
1-1.
Hit softly on the ground to first. Scooped up, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that brings up the shortstop, J.P. Crawford. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. In there for strike one.
This could be a huge win for the guy on the mound if he's able to get out of this inning 1-2-3 and start fresh next inning with the middle of the order.
Two out, nobody on. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Mariners are down in order. They still trail 1-0. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Tigers manager Ron Gardenhire during the break about the team's offensive performance so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Next will be the cleanup hitter, C.J. Krohn, comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Krohn. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch.
0-1 to the count.
Here comes the 0-1.
One ball, two strikes.
I love a well-executed changeup, especially one down in the zone. The only problem throwing it in that situation, you leave that belt high or miss your spot just a hair, and you could have some problems.
And he fouls this one off. Now a swing and a fly ball. But this will wind up being a foul ball. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
He put up a pretty good battle at the plate right there. They finally get him on a 1-2 pitch, but you could see that he wasn't laying down without a fight. He really made the pitcher earn that strikeout.
Here's Jonathan Scope now as he takes a cold strike at the knees. It's 0-1. He's 0-for-1 thus far. And it's 0-2 to Scope.
Count 0-2.
And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number two.
fool him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
First offering on its way. Jeimer Candelario is at the plate as he watches ball one.
One run on three hits and no errors in the ballgame for the Tigers.
Swing and a liner. Foul.
The 1-1.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. On the run is Lewis. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Down in order go the Tigers, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Bottom of the inning now, and into bat next, the third baseman, Kyle Seager.
The third baseman, Kyle Seager.
Outfield shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch.
1-0.
The 1-0. Turned on, but it's wide of first and foul. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Ball three.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
And it's fouled away. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. Pretty clear he didn't like the call there on the outside part of the plate, but probably too good to take, and he's down on strikes for the second time.
Yeah, that pitch was right on the black. Beautiful pitch, and even if we had robot umps, he'd still be out. But the only difference would be he wouldn't be able to complain about it.
Stepping in now, Tom Murphy, as he'll take a look at ball one. Wind up and the 1-0 pitch. Swing and a miss, 1-1. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1. Pitch on the way. Right down the middle with a changeup, but not what he was looking for, taken for a strike. Fouled away. Another 2-2 offering. Hard hit ball to second. Taken in by Scope. Throw on to first. Two gone.
Now batting.
Stepping in, Daniel Vogelbach. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. A little too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. Swing and a miss. A little too anxious there. 1-1.
He's going to step out of the box, adjust his batting gloves, and pray he gets the exact same pitch as that one. Because if it comes again, we like to refer to that one in the biz as a cement mixer.
And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Wanted to go after the slider, but he holds off. 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Base hit into right center.
You take a look at the numbers up to this point. You see he's only given up two hits so far today, so he's been hitting his spots all game long. Remains to be seen if he can keep that shutout intact going forward, but I'm not betting against him.
At the plate now, Kyle Lewis. As he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half, it's 0-1. Looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat. Here comes the 0-1. And here's a curveball that just about got away as it misses inside for a ball.
He's got to find a way to grab some composure out there and not let this inning get away from him. He was dominating, and now he goes out and gives up a two-out single and then almost drills a guy. Get back in the zone.
One and two now. In tight with the slider, 2-2. No runs, two hits, and no errors in the game for the Mariners to this point. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
Good running count right here. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, runner on first. He'll be off to the races on this pitch.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. The next 3-2. And another foul ball. Hit out towards second. Scope has it. Throw in time, and the side is retired. One left for Seattle. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. So digging in now, Kristen Stewart. He'll start off the fifth in this one.
Number 14.
From the stretch. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Bounce to the right into the loaded up infield. He's got it. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. One out now here in the Tiger fifth inning. And up next, the catcher, Austin Romine. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Nope, outside.
One out, nobody on. This is foul right side. Hit on the ground out to short. Crawford fields it cleanly. And the throw is low that time to first. And did he have control of it? Yes, says the first base umpire. And there are two gone. Digging in, Jacoby Jones. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
And he'll get under it to put it away in foul territory, and that ends the inning. So they breeze through this half of the inning. Home half of the fifth coming up. The Tigers lead it 1-0. Welcome back to T-Mobile Park in Seattle as we send it down to Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Mariners manager Scott Servais during the break about his team's offensive performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. No, they have not scored yet, but they have been successful in running up the pitch count, something they feel will eventually pay dividends on the scoreboard as the starter gets tired and they are forced to go to the bullpen. For now, they're sticking to the plan.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Stepping into the box, Jake Fraley. They'll start things out here in the home fifth, and it's been tough sledding for this lineup through the first half of the game.
Yeah, they haven't had any momentum going to the plate so far in this one, Matt. They need something to break their way and wake them up a bit.
Be nice to get these fans involved at some point as well. Now the pitch. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike. Here's a weakly hit fly ball off to the left side. In there, a base hit.
Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
Digging in now, Evan White. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got to bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
He's set, and the pitch. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Hit sharply on the ground, and that finds its way through for a base hit.
Yeah, batting averages are much better 1-0 in a count than they are when the count is even. They opted to go with a pitch out to lead off the at-bat, and it obviously cost them. No real damage done yet, but now they've even got a tougher situation to deal with.
So here's Malik Smith as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one.
Well, they've yet to hang a number on the scoreboard, but it looks like they've got a great opportunity from the breakthrough. Going to be pretty demoralizing if they can't.
And this will be fouled away. The 1-1 is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Great pitch in that situation. If he makes contact on that one, more than likely he's hitting into a double play.
Lays off 2-2 now.
Yeah, doubled up on the slider away there. Got him to go after it before, so why not see if he'll offer at it again?
First and second here with nobody out. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
It's been a really rough day for this lineup. There's really no other way to say it. Not a lot of good scoring opportunities, and when they've had them, like right now, it's just been an uphill battle for them to make anything positive happen.
Into the box, Shed Long, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
Hey, this isn't exactly the way you'd like to draw it up. Not throwing a lot of first pitch strikes.
Now a fastball here, not close, and it's 1-1 now. Two and one count now to the Mariners' leadoff batter.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Hit out towards second, and that'll get by into center field for a base hit. And the tying run comes around to score from second. And now time will be called here as you see the pitching coach making his way out to the mound to pay a quick visit. Standing in now, J.P. Crawford, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Inside, and he falls behind the hitter now, 2-0.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
Two and oh pitch on the way.
I got 3-0.
There's Kyle Seager in the on deck circle. We'll see him next. He's set. Here's the 3-0. And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1.
3-1 with 2 on, and this is where you got to be geared up for something to drive. I don't think you can just groove him one right here. You still have to try to make a competitive pitch.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Hard on the ground towards short. To second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Mariners forced to settle for one. Five innings complete, all tied at 1-1. Digging in to try it again, Cameron Maven comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. He's set. Here it comes.
Nope, up there.
Now the 1-0. Runs a bit inside for a ball. And it's 2-1 to the Tigers' leadoff hitter.
Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Boy, this is a tight one. You kind of get the feeling like the next team that scores is going to win this one.
Now the 2-1 pitch is taken for strike two.
Two balls, two strikes.
And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. Nico Goodrum is on deck. Line drive snagged on a short hop. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
The batter.
Digging in once again, Nico Goodrum. A fly out and a single for him so far. Here comes the first pitch. Bottom part of the zone, a good changeup gets the call. Oh, got him a swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing in two.
His command has been outstanding so far, hitting nearly all of the spots, and that's been a big factor why he's been so successful up to this point.
Hit hard on the ground to first, and that is going to sneak on through into right. It's a one-out single.
Dan, are you even concerned about that? You've been pitching out of the windup all game, and now you have to go to the stretch.
It can be a concern sometimes, D-Row, but you try to in between starts to make sure that you throw enough pitches out of the stretch, and he's been out of the windup most of the game, so we'll see how he reacts here after this base hit.
Drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing in one.
Hey, it's not always about filling up the strike zone all the time every inning. He's pitching well as we're moving into the middle innings, but interestingly, less than 50% of his first pitches have been for strikes.
Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count, and the pitch.
Nope, at the ball.
That's a good but risky take there on 0-2. Some umpires have no problem ringing you up on a pitch that close.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. On a rope to the second baseman. But the runner is back to avoid the double play.
Now batter, the first baseman, CJ.
So that'll bring up CJ Crone. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
And another throw over, keeping particularly close tabs on him. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
Nope.
Hey, this one's tied late in the game. As a pitcher right now, you just can't lay a cookie in there 1-0.
Runner aboard at first here with two gone in a 1-1 ball game. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
You never want to fall behind as a pitcher, but doing it to a guy like this is even worse. He's got to bear down and execute for the rest of this at bat, starting right now.
The count now at 2-1. Has a look, now the pitch. Offers it that one a little late, and it's 2-2 now.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
Here now the 2-2. Is laid off, and the count runs full.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with the man in scoring position.
So that'll bring up Jonathan Schoop. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Ball one. Hard hit ball to second. Throw on to first, and the Tigers wind up with nothing as the inning is over. No runs, a hit, two left. To the bottom of the sixth inning, all tied at 1-1. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and set to go is the third baseman, Kyle Seager.
Kyle Seager.
First pitch of the at-bat.
Hey, it's a game of execution. If the pitcher stays right there, this lineup's going to continue to have a tough time.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. And right into the shift. Schoop is there. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
Now batter.
Settling in now, Tom Murphy. He was a ground out victim last time up. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Low for ball one. That swung on and missed. We're even at 1-1.
Although he doesn't use that pitch too much, if he's able to steal some strikes early in the count, could be something they have to think about.
There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. To 2-2 now.
Next out, 2-2.
So a full count now.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
Three, two pitch. And he misses ball four.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Now here comes Ron Gardenhire up out of the dugout. And a change is in the offing, as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. He'll depart with our score tied, and he'll still be accountable for the runner at first, and the best he can do is a no decision in this one.
T Tyler Alexander enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning.
Tyler Alexander.
Daniel Vogelbach will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. From the belt, the pitch. Swing and a miss out in front of a changeup.
This is where you step out, adjust the batting gloves, and take a deep breath. You have to slow the moment down. I know you want to be a hero, but that pitch right there, a great executed changeup, had this batter way out in front.
A 1-1. In the dirt. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And a very big mistake as that'll move the possible go-ahead run into scoring position. The 2-1 home. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. And that nearly broke our tie, but instead it's a foul ball. Again, he sends it out of play. Now another 2-2.
Three balls, two strikes.
Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
Looked to me like he had the right idea with the swing on that pitch, and he just didn't get the bat through the zone in time. The pitch was away. He let it get deep, maybe trying to take it the other way, but it got too deep and was by him by the time his barrel could get in the correct position.
Into the box now, Kyle Lewis. As the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. Alexander stands 6-2 and throws from the left side. He's in his rookie year here at the big league level. 1-0, here it is. Hit on the ground out to short. Reined in. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Mariners leave one. Score remains deadlocked at one. Dan Altavilla is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven. Seventh inning ready to roll, and next will be the switch hitting third baseman, Jeimer Candelario. First pitch of the at bat, fouled off. Oh, one, here's the pitch. High in the air out to center field. Smith is right there. And he's got it for out number one. Into the box, Kristen Stewart. No hits to this point. From the stretch, here's the pitch. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. And down in the Mariner bullpen, it looks like a right-hander's up to throw. Here comes the 0-1.
That's not a bad pitch right there. That two-seamer moving away from a left-handed hitter. Didn't get the strike, but I like the idea behind the pitch.
Bases are empty, one man out. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball. Wanted to go after the slider, but he holds off 3-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Seager fields it cleanly. Throw on to first will get him. Score it 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now.
Austin Romine.
Digging in, Austin Romine. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Here comes the first pitch.
Well, count 1-0.
Altavilla is at least partially known for his big power slider. A lot of break on that pitch, but what makes it unique is how hard he's able to throw it. The 2-0 on the way. 3-0 now.
Well, he was definitely looking fastball here, and he got one, but that was good discipline to lay off and get himself into a 3-0 count.
The pitch. And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Up next for the Tigers, the center fielder, Jacoby.
Striding into the box, Jacoby Jones. Third at bat in this one. He's bounced out and popped out in his two previous trips. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. In there, and it's even at one.
Hey, it looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball.
That's how you open up the outside part of the plate. Pound two balls in, and then get right back outside. Nice pitch.
Liner toward right center. And that finds a seam for extra bases, as we'll see if they want to wheel that go-ahead run home from first. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
The good news for pitchers in this park is that it doesn't give up many home runs. A lot of room in the outfield. Sometimes that's the bad news as well, though, because there's a lot of space for hits to get down and to go for extra bases just like that.
Ready now, Cameron Maven. He was a ground-out victim last time up. First pitch on its way. No balls and a strike to count. Comes set, the 0-1. Hit hard on the ground at first. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Tigers strand a pair. Still tied, one apiece. Last half of the seventh here. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Jake Fraley.
The left fielder. Number 8.
First pitch coming. Here it is. In there for strike 1, 0-1. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Maben is there, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Digging in now for the Mariners, Evan White, 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. The pitch. One out, nobody on. Breaking ball below the zone, that's ball one. Two balls and a strike to the Mariners' first baseman. Now the 2-1 pitch. Taken, strike two. Takes this the other way to right. And that's in for his second hit of the afternoon.
Nothing fires me up more than watching an offensive player stay inside a baseball and drive it the other way.
Malik Smith the next to hit. And this one's in the dirt. And a nice job keeping it close. It's ball one. For the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. And a dive, but he's back in. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. Oh, much too tardy on the fastball. 1-1. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball. Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. Swing and a liner. The 1-2. Hit to third. Fielded cleanly. To second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. Mark, Dan, and I are back with more after this. Carl Edwards Jr. has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 16, Carl Edwards Jr.
Striding in once again, Nico Goodrum, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
Well, if you're looking for pop, he definitely has more pop, more home run potential hitting from the left side. This is his power side.
And the first pitch of the inning here misses down and in for a ball. It's 1-0. And he fouls this one off. Edwards, a right-hander standing 6'3". He was taken in the very late rounds back in 2011.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
1-1.
No catch off the plate. Ball two.
Swings through it for strike number two.
He's having a great day at the dish. His timing is spot on. This pitching staff's going to have to find a different way of attacking him.
Full count now. 3-2. Danger looms on deck here in the person of Miguel Cabrera. Curveball got him swinging for the first out.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
To the plate now, Miguel Cabrera, as he'll watch a first pitch curveball drop in there for strike one. We could really use a knock here, 0-3 in the game so far. And it's quickly 0-2.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Trying to get Cabrera to chase there, but it's 1-2.
He didn't look overly fooled right there because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff 0-2, but he certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Here's C.J. Cron now. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. And it's fouled away. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on him. 1-2.
I'll tell you, if I'm pitching right now, I'm not throwing anything near the strike zone until these guys prove they can lay off it.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. The three of us are back with more following this. Bottom of inning number eight set to go. And set to go is the second baseman, Shed Long. First delivery to him on the way. And there's his strike right down the heart of the plate, 0-1. And it looks like a right-hander's gotten up to throw in the Tiger bullpen. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
That's a ball.
High in the air down the right field line. And he will make the catch while ranging backward as he just put the glove up and hauled it in for the first out.
J.P.
Ready once again, J.P. Crawford. First offering on its way. Lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The windup and the 0-1.
Hey.
Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out.
That was a big strikeout there, guys. The best pitchers have the ability to strike guys out when they really need to. And that second out was really important at this point of the game. Could be something we look back on later when the game's over.
In now, Kyle Seager. As he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty, it's strike one. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Into the wind, the 0-1. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
Those were two great executed pitches right there away from this batter. He can hurt you in a heartbeat. I don't think anything's going to leak out over the heart of the plate.
The 1-2. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. 1-2-3 go the Mariners. Score remains tied 1-1. Ready for another shot now. Jonathan Schoop. He starts off the inning against a guy who struck out the side last inning. How do they get to him here?
I'm not sure, Matt, that they want to stay as patient. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. They might want to start swinging a little bit earlier in the count.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And we kick off the ninth inning with a swinging strike here. Nothing and one.
Hey, not too often we see this hitter come outside his game plan, outside the zone, but that pitch was just so tempting.
Now the 0-1.
Ball, that's inside.
Wanted to get the front door curveball on the inside corner there, but it backed up a little and stayed off the corner.
And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Now a ball fouled down the right field line out of play, so that'll move the count to 2-2 now. Pitch on the way. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2.
Looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
Pitch on the way. Fouled away. Another full count pitch home. High in the air down the right field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
And that at-bat will put a smile on any manager's face. The pitch total of the opposing pitcher just keeps going higher and higher, and he still couldn't put him away. So this inning is off to a good start for the guys carrying the sticks.
Stepping up to the plate, Jeimer Candelario. Go-ahead run at first, nobody out. Here's the first pitch. And he'll try to bunt that man to second, but this one kicks foul. Go-ahead runs aboard here at first with nobody out. Now a bunt attempt here as he gets this one down. And the throw is late at first, so they can't get anybody out.
Now batting, number 14.
So striding forward now, Kristen Stewart. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Here's the first pitch. Now a bunt attempt here. And the throw goes to first, so the sacrifice works that time.
Go-ahead run to third there after the bunt. Sacrifices aren't everyone's favorite play because you give up precious outs, but they do have a lot of ways now to take the lead.
So a big moment in the ball game here. Austin Romine. And he could very well get the intentional pass here, as that would set up a potential double play ball that might keep the game tied. The 0-1. Strike two.
Well, this is a strikeout situation, but it's also a ground ball situation. I expect we'll see a lot of pitches down in the zone trying to prevent the hitter from getting the ball up in the air.
Curveball bounces, and that gets by to the backstop. Good work there to prevent any advance. It's 1-2. Swing and a fly ball. This ought to at least get the go-ahead run in. Catch is made. Here comes the go-ahead run for the plate. He's in there at the plate. And here in the ninth, they have taken the lead.
Hey, putting together good at-bats late in the games can really help out. And how about this sac fly right here? Good at-bat that leads to his team getting the lead here in the late innings.
digging in and looking for more, Jacoby Jones, runner in scoring position with two gone. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Well outside with the curveball for a ball.
Well, that curveball was really a hanger, and that's not a good sign. He's got to get back on track. He needs that release point to get out front and get the ball down in the zone.
Good take there to lay off the high fastball.
This inning really feels like it's getting away from him out there. As a reliever, you can't let that happen. Nothing you can do about what's already happened, and it's only going to get worse if you're not focusing on the guy in the batter's box.
The set and the 2-0. And that misses as well, 3-0.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
He's set. The 3-0 offering. There's a strike with the fastball as he gets back in the count at 3-1.
Stealing that strike on 3-0 was important, but you don't want to miss over the heart of the plate in this situation. I got to believe he's going to be way more aggressive right here.
Ready with the 3-1. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
The right fielder, number four.
Brendan Brennan takes over now with two gone here in the top of inning number nine.
Now pitching for the Mariners, number 65, Brandon Brennan.
Cameron Maben will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and two away. Looking to minimize the damage here. Hard hit ball to second. Scooped up. And how about that right out of the bullpen? A ground ball on one pitch and the inning is over. Tigers get just the one. On to the bottom of inning number nine. 4, 5, and 6 coming up. It's the Tigers 2 and the Mariners 1. Joe Jimenez comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth. Striding forward now, the Mariners' cleanup hitter, Tom Murphy. It was a walk in his last trip. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. They'll try and entice him with a high fastball, but he wouldn't commit. It's ball one. Swing and a ball pulled hard down the line in left. And I believe your tying run's going to be in scoring position right away as this is down for extra bases. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with the single swing of the bat, and this might be their chance right here. They've struggled to produce a lot of runs, but there he is at second base. A shot to the outfield scores him. Then who knows what kind of roll they could get on. Got to take it one good at-bat at a time.
Dan Vogelbach is next. He'll go to work on getting that tying run home from second. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss, and he's behind 0-1.
Looking for a productive at-bat here. Get that runner from second over to third.
Now an off-speed pitch that nearly ran in and got him.
Well, this team, they're swinging at everything, but that pitch was just a little too far out of the strike zone.
1-1. Fastball well outside. No one out with a runner at second. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
So now to the plate, Kyle Lewis. And he'll take a look at ball one. Pitch on the way. Line to the right side. Maven will have plenty of room as he makes the catch, and there's a big out number two.
Now batter number eight.
So a big moment here, and standing in, Jake Fraley. And he does so representing the possible go-ahead run. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery.
Now for a note.
One and oh. Here it is. Swing and a miss, and they're up against it now as they're down to their final strike of the afternoon.
I wouldn't be surprised if he used his aggressiveness against him right here. If you're going to get a swing outside the zone, 1-1, might as well fish a little bit further.
Last chance for the Mariners. Struck him out, so he'll strand the possible tying run at second, and a great job of working out of trouble as this ball game is over.
Well, that's just a great job of battling on the road. They fought all the way to the end, took the lead in the top of the ninth, and secured the W in the bottom half. That's a great team win.
Pitching and defense game, 2-1, the final score this afternoon. The Tigers came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Tyler Alexander is credited with the win. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Here now is our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Tigers, 2 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 8 men on base. For the Mariners, 1 run, 7 hits, no errors. They left 9 runners on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 35 minutes.